savor for a long time. It's not something like flowers that just die with them. I'm practical. How's that? Don't keep it before the stone, dude. Yeah, because I got away with it. She was glad to get the time.
Shauna.
Sixth grade class. What a beautiful morning and what a beautiful group of students. It was great today. Join me in welcoming the guests that we have here today. This is Luann Rivera, one of Pomona Unified. And then not guests, but very important people on the right side of my stage. Mrs. Ingrid Forbes. Numbers even to 10. Today you are proficient readers and mathematicians. You are capable of writing beautiful essays with clear thought and purpose. Research comes to you with great ease, whether you're using an old-fashioned book or the internet. Sixth graders, you have today come to the end of your elementary school years, and soon you'll find yourselves beginning again. First in middle school, then in high school, and parents, sooner than you think, college and careers. Although you still have much to do, I can tell you with great pride and admiration that you leave us prepared. You are ready for the challenges that middle school will bring to you. Your preparation and training comes from you and your commitment to your education, your parents and their commitment to you, and finally, the excellence in education that you have received here at Mount Woodson this year, and of course, the many years that came before sixth grade. Earlier this week, one of your teachers came to me with a huge smile on her face. She was proud. As you know, students, your teachers have kept you working down to the last minute. Your teacher wanted to share one of the assignments she had given to you, poetry. You were to write a poem centering on school days and this final year in Mount Woodson. As we discussed the lesson, she shared student work, and she pointed out one that I believe is worth sharing today. This was The Year by Sean Nicholson. Students, as I read this poem, ask yourselves if what Sean put to paper has meaning to you. This was the year my buddy showed me that I was still a kid at heart. This was the year I didn't do my best. I got into trouble, and I didn't turn in my work. This was the year that I have kept true friends and have made more. This is the year I learned to live with other kids. This is the year that nature called me towards her and taught me her ways. This was the year I learned I was good at something. This was the year I got shoved around and ended up in trouble. This is the year I learned that I need to look ahead. This is the year I learned I was maturing. I learned I was growing tired of children's games. This was the year that I found I didn't have to be like everyone else to fit in. This was the year that I learned and found myself. Students, families, and friends, let's begin the promotion ceremony for Mount Woodson sixth grade class.
Good morning, everyone. I just want to say that it's a distinct pleasure to be here with you, watch these sixth graders move on to the next level of their education. I know they're going to face many challenges ahead and have great successes. And to congratulate all the parents, friends, and family members who are here to share this beautiful event with them. I have a special opportunity today to award the Perfect Attendance Award. And this year, seven sixth grade students achieved the Perfect Attendance Award. These students made a commitment to be present all 180 days this year. That's quite an achievement, so I think we should be very proud of them. We also need to thank their parents and be very proud of them because, as we all know, as parents, it's a very hard commitment to make sure that the students get to school every day. And we're really pleased that these students were here every single day at Mount Wilson and taking full advantage of their educational opportunities here. When I call your name, please stand. From Mrs. Mumford's class, Mr. Gregory Burrow. Todd LaGuardia, second vice president. Nicole Lang, secretary. Taylor Thomas, treasurer. Logan Groom, activities chairman. This group of young people have dedicated many hours of service to Mount Wilson. Many of them not only this year, but through fourth, fifth, and sixth grade. They are responsible, hardworking, and caring individuals. They have participated. Thank you. As you know from our previous award ceremony, honor roll students are students who have earned an A-minus average for the quarter and have received all E's and G's on their report card, no S's, N's, or U's. Students, when I call your name, please stand. Sonia Aguilera, Kim Andrews, Travis Begley, Margarita Gordillo, Logan Grooms, Emily Hermes, Todd LaGuardia, Nicole Lang, Michael Lara, Megan Leach, Megan McNerney, Ashley Misevic, Whitney Noble, Heather Skaggs, Michelle Sewell, William Sterling, Lance Swift, Taylor Thomas, Brianna Thompson, Josh Tobias, Brenna Tucker. Good morning. It's my pleasure to announce the Be Your Better Award. And the Be Your Better Award is awarded to those students who have a B average or better on their fourth quarter report card. Please stand when I announce your name. Kyle Adelman, Taylor Alio, Cassandra Aldridge, Carlin Boyle, Brianna Bradburn, Carrie Carr, Corey Collier, Megan Colwell, April Cordova, Lauren Denning, Dulcinea Garibay, Judy Garza, Trevor Grover, Katie Hoffman, Lori Hove, Chelsea Lightfoot, Cody Lloyd, Robin Morgan, Brianna Mickey, Taylor Mickey, Jessica Murphy, Robert Award.
Students who receive the Fine Arts Awards, a lot of them have been nominated by our art teacher, Ms. Kroll, and so would you please stand when I call your name? Kyle Adelman, Jose Aguilar, Brandy Oss, Trevor Dial, Nick Philweber, Emily Hermes, Brianna James, Patrick Godgers, Nicole Perez, and Brianna have shown improved effort this following and last quarter. Travis Begley, Brianna Bradner, Chelsea Head, Ashley Kohler, Miles Leslie, Brandon Curo, Jillian Rambo.
More than one school year, the students' names that I'm going to read have an A-minus average for fourth, fifth, and sixth grade, and have achieved an 85th percentile or higher on their standardized testing. So it truly is an academic award that they should be very proud of.
Sonia Aguilera, Kim Andrews, Logan Grooms, Emily Hermes, Todd LaGuardia, Nicole Lang, Michael Lara, Megan Leach, Megan McNerney, Michelle Sewell, Lance Swift, Taylor Thomas, and Brenna Tucker. Congratulations.
Citizenship Award goes to a special young man who not only worked hard on student council, but also coordinated the music at every assembly for over a year. In addition, he spent countless hours fixing the computers and helping both teachers and students. Congratulations to Logan Grooms.
I wish that was it, but that's what I did have a teaching. things I wanted to share. I know anytime there's an event like this, there's probably many of the adults here. We all go back to when we graduated from sixth grade. And for me, that was back in 1964. My family was at that time living in Ethiopia. And we had a great opportunity there to interact with a lot of people from all over the world. In fact, in my sixth grade class, there was someone from Iran, someone from Brazil, people from France, one from Germany. I learned something that year that has stuck with me the rest of my life. And this is where you may have already realized it because I'm not a different audience. But when my parents went in for a parent-teacher conference, my brother's teacher, after talking at great length, finally stopped and looked at my parents and said, "That voice is genuine." I said, "Yes, that voice is genuine." And it was at that point I realized it was a student's responsibility to get the education, to get the learning. The teacher can present all they want and do all the wonderful things they do, but it is up to us and it's up to you to come in. And you have done that now, starting with kindergarten, on through to today. And you need to be proud of what you've done. There's a lot ahead of you, so I say that you stay tuned in. Now, that has been a lot of team thinking. So a lot of you have learned from it. Those of you who have gained knowledge from Mrs. Plunkett, raise your hand. Those of you who have, and I don't mean learning the macarena. All of you who have learned from Mrs. Forbes. All of you finally got old enough to find that he could retire. He retired for about a year in this big company and with big machines and multi-dollar machines. Came to him one day and said, "We have 1 month to get the machines down and we need it. We need it. Would you mind coming out of retirement for one day and helping us out?" Well, he did it. And he spent all day looking that machine over, checking it out. And at the end of the day, he took a piece of chalk and he marked a little X in front of one of the components, and they replaced the components on the machine, and it worked perfectly, and they got it on the and they said, "$50,000, do you mind if you write in exactly what it was you had $1 for the top market, and $49,999. The education that man had afforded him a wonderful opportunity. Nobody can take that away from him, the knowledge he had. If he was able to help, no one can take the knowledge that he had, which in the world today is a marvelous thing. You read and you write and you have some basics. And now you will start to build on it. You have come to school every morning. In this free land, you come to the school where you and you have pledged allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. And what a wonderful state you live in. And I can't imagine anywhere in this state there's more wonderful a community or a more wonderful elementary school than I can. Come on, it's not worth my hand. And as you have done this, have you come and put your hand over your heart and then each and every individual that makes this life worth living. With the choices you have created for yourself, you can have them. So I would like to say, as you move on, as you move up, have everybody's heart here with you, cheering you on. And I would just like to show you what moving on and moving up. How many of you would ever like to be in a bird? You like to fly? And because you can see and you can go. And that's exactly what happens when you move on and you move up. The Mount Whitman, the most in class of 2000. I congratulate you as you move on.
Thank you. teachers, our students, and our parent families. As you take our precious sixth graders away from us today, please take good care of them, for they are our future. This concludes the promotion ceremony. Our students will be exiting through the center aisle, and they'll meet you in the Shining Star Cafe for refreshments.